And the Duchess is going to be furious. I was supposed to escort her to the palace garden for the Queen of Hearts croquet tournament. If we're late for that, the Queen is bound to chop off my head. That's the penalty for being late.
Oh, dear. I've seen quite a few rabbits before, but never one that kept a watch in his pocket. He must have gone down that rabbit hole. Quite a large rabbit hole. Big enough for me.
She has a dreadful temper.
Off with their heads, I say!
Duchess! Won't she be savage if I've kept her waiting?
Off with her head!
No time, no time! Oh, no time!
Sir! You dropped your gloves. Oh. I'm so afraid and homesick. Oh. Oh. Stop crying. You should be ashamed of yourself, a big girl like you. Yesterday, things were just as usual. I changed during the night. But if I'm not the same as I was,
wretched sorrow, my dear paws, my fur and whiskers. She'll have me executed as sure as carrots are carrots. Where did I put them? I had them at the house, and shortly after I got here, I can't seem to keep them on me anymore. Where are they? Run home this minute and fetch me a pair of gloves, quick now.
Yeah. not if you ever want to go home.
Why do you say that?
Many who go to the palace never go home at all. They lose their heads over it.
Oh, but I've done no harm to anyone.
You'll be accused of something before the day is out. Mark my words. Let me give you some advice before it's too late.
Please do.
When the time comes, use your wish. Use your wish, my girl.
Wow, 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 wow.
I speak severely to my
boy, I meet him when he sneezes. For he can thoroughly enjoy the pepper when he pleases.
Yes, true.
the March Hare. He's the Hatter.
And this sleepy thing is the Dormouse.
Have some wine.
I don't see any wine.
Well, there isn't any.
Then it wasn't very nice of you to offer it.
Well, it wasn't very nice of you to sit down without being invited.
I didn't know it was your table.
Oh, your hair needs cutting.
You should learn not to make personal remarks. It's rude.
Why is a raven
like a writing desk?
I believe I can guess that.
Do you mean that you
think
you could find out the answer to it?
Exactly so.
Well, then why don't you say what you mean?
I do. At least, I think I mean what I say. That's the same thing, you know.
Not the same thing a bit. Why, you might just as well say that I see what I eat is the same as I eat what I see.
You might as well say that I like what I get is the same thing as I get what I like.
Oh, you might as well just say that I breathe when I sleep is the same thing as I sleep when I breathe.
It is the same with you.
What date is it?
The 4th.
Oh, 2 days wrong? I told you not to stuff butter in the gears.
But it was the best butter.
I don't quite understand this.
The Dormouse is asleep again. Of course, just as you wish. Have you guessed the riddle yet?
I give up. What's the answer?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Nor I.
Think you might do something better with time than asking riddles that have no answer.
If you knew time as well as I do, you wouldn't talk about this thing yet. It's him.
I don't know what you mean.
Of course you don't. I dare say you never even spoke to time.
Then the Dormouse shall
wake up, Dormouse!
It was a
Dear will be asleep before it's done. Once upon a time, there were three little sisters, and their names were Elsie, Lacey, and Tilly. And they all lived at the bottom of a well.
What did they live on?
Have some more tea.
Well, I've had none yet, so I can't take more.
You mean you can't take less? It's very easy to take more than nothing.
Nobody asked your opinion.
Who's making personal remarks now?
Why do they live at the bottom of the well?
It was a syrup well.
There's no such thing.
Shh.
But what if they can't
Hey, if you can't be polite, then you might as well. And so, these three little sisters, they were learning to draw, you know.
What did they draw?
Maple syrup. Oh. I want a clean cup. Let's all move again!
You can't possibly miss it. Now go! Oh, let her, my dear. She is only a child.
I forgive her on the grounds of youth. Turn them over.
Yes, Auntie. I mean, yes, Your Royal Majesty.
Please, no. Get
them on their feet, the miserable wretches. Stop that ridiculous bargain! You're making me giddy. What have you been doing here?
If you please, Your Majesty, if you are just...
Off with their heads!
Oh, Your Majesty, please! Have mercy!
Take them away!
Please, this is all just one thing.
But what about the
Council? The Council! The Council!
The Council! The Council!
Pay attention to me!
Flamingos from now. It's so amusing, don't you agree?
Is she really going to chop off their heads?
Well, yes. Fine day, isn't it?
My head before!
Venice. I'm doubtful about the temper of your flamingo. Shall I try the experiment?
You might fight.
Right you are. Flamingos and mustard. Both bite. And the moral of that is, birds of a feather flock together.
Only mustard isn't a bird.
Right as usual. Very clear way you have of putting things.
Mustard is a mineral, I think.
Of course it is. There's a large mustard mine near here. And the moral of that is, the more there is of mine, the less there is of yours.
I'd understand that better if I had it written down.
Oh, that's nothing to what I could say. A fine day, Your Majesty.
I give you fair warning. You must get ready for your execution or I'll chop off your head!
Day to day.
Well, then the 11th day was a holiday.
Of course it was.
about the games.
Now, you may not have lived much under the sea.
I haven't.
Perhaps you've never been introduced to a lobster before.
Well, I once tasted. No, never.
Then perhaps you don't know what such a delightful thing a lobster quadrille is.
Lobster quadrille? Isn't that a dance?
Would you like to see a bit of it?
Very much.
Come, let us dance the lobster quadrille. It can be done without lobsters, don't you know?
Will the queen allow it?
We won't tell her.
You sing.
Will you walk a little faster? Said the whiting to a snail. There's a porpoise right beside us, and he's treading on my tail. See how eagerly the lobsters and the turtles all advance. They are waiting on a shingle. Oh, won't you come and join the dance? Will you join the dance? Will you join the dance? You can really have no notion how delightful it will be when they take us up and throw us with the lobsters out to sea. But the snail replied too far, and gave a look askance. Everything the whiting kindly, but he would not join the dance. Would not join the dance. Would not join the dance.
Do you know why it's called a whiting?
No.
Because it polishes our boots.
The whiting polishes your boots?
What are your shoes done with?
Blacking, I believe.
Well, boots and shoes I want to see are done with whiting. Now you know.
What are they made of?
Soles and heels, of course. Any old shrimp could have told you that.
If I was the whiting of the song, I would have told the poor miss, keep back. We don't want you with us.
No ice fish would go anywhere without a porpoise.
Wouldn't it really?
If a fish came up to me and said he was going on an adventure, I'd say, with what porpoise?
Would you like to dance again, or would you like the mock turtle to sing you a song?
Oh, a song, please.
Singer, turtle soup, will you, old fella?
All rich and green, waiting in our hearts to lean. For such dainties would not stoop, soup of the evening, beautiful soup. Soup of the evening, beautiful soup. That's not yet. It's a great deal to come before any of that.
Call the first witness.
First witness, Mad Hatter, Mad Hatter.
Off with her head! Off with her head!
Stop! Stop! I haven't done
seen gardens compared with which this would be a wilderness.
I thought I'd try to make it to the top of that hill.
When you say hill, I could show you hills compared with which that would be a valley.
A hill can't be a valley, you know. Well, that would be nonsense.
I've heard nonsense compared with which that would be as sensible as a dictionary.
This must be the Looking Glass Land. It's marked out just like a large chessboard. A huge game of chess being played all over the world. If this is the world at all. Wait! I remember! If I could cross the chessboard, then I can become queen, and if I can become queen, then I can go home!
That's easily managed. When you reach the 8th square, you'll become queen. Come along!
What shall we repeat to her?
The
The Walrus and the Carpenter. That's the longest.
Oh!
Down and listen. The Walrus and the Carpenter were walking on the strand. They wept like anything to see such quantities of sand. If this were only cleared away, they said it would be grand.
Oh, oysters come and walk with us, the Walrus did beseech. A pleasant walk, a pleasant talk along the briny beach. We cannot do with more than four to give a hand to each.
Then four young oysters hurried up, all eager for the treat. Their coats were brushed, their faces washed, their shoes were clean and neat. And this was odd, because, you know, they hadn't any feet.
Sit down.
Four other oysters hurried up, and yet another four. Thick and fast they came at last, and more and more and more. All hopping through the frothy waves, scrambling to the shore.
The Walrus and the Carpenter walked on a mile or so, and then they rested on a rock, really low, and all the little oysters stood and waited in a row.
How much longer?
Sit down.
The time has come, the Walrus said, to talk of many things, of shoes and ships and sealing wax, of cabbages and kings, and why the sea is boiling hot, and whether pigs have wings.
A loaf of bread, the Walrus said, is what we chiefly need. Pepper and vinegar besides are very good indeed. Now if you're ready, oysters dear, we can begin to feed.
But not on us, the oysters cried, turning a little blue. After such a kindness, that'd be a dismal thing to do. The night is fine, the Walrus said. Do you admire the view?
Sit down.
It seems a shame, the Walrus said, to play them such a trick, after we brought them out so far and made them trot so quick. The Carpenter said nothing but, the butter's spread too thick.
I weep for you, the Walrus said, I deeply sympathize. With sobs and tears he sorted out those of the largest size, holding his pocket handkerchief before his streaming eyes.
Oh, oysters, said the Carpenter, you've had a pleasant run. Shall we be trotting home again? But answer came there none. But this was scarcely odd, because they'd eaten everyone!
Effect of living backwards. It makes one a little giddy.
crowned queen.
I won't, my love. I won't.
Then stir your stumps.
Listen carefully.
I sent a message to the fish. I told them this is what I wish. The little fish's answer was, we cannot do it, sir, because...
That's your advice?
The important part is coming. Then someone came to me and said, the little fishes are in bed. I took a corkscrew from the shelf. I went to wake them up myself. And when I found the door was locked, I pulled and pushed and kicked and knocked. And when I found the door was shut, I tried to turn the handle, but...
Is that all?
And so my advice is... Run!
I beg your pardon?
Run for your life! It's a queen of hearts! Run! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
With 90 times 9.
And welcome!